Hell, oh yeah. I went downstairs after I recorded the previous part, that's why. So how many did we record? I think it was up to 5 now. 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is the one I'm currently recording. And of course I need to upload the remaining ones, the virtual ticket ones, those are 3. These ones I'm gonna wait with uploading until I'm done with everything else. So you have these 3 left. So 1, 2, 3, and then 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9, and then I'm gonna uploading these 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and then the remaining Dark End Wars 15, 16, 17, and then all the League and Concerts and Osis, including the bonus episodes and stuff that. So there's 2 episodes, but there's a lot of parts. So 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. So 30 left, and this is the Demon Hunter 1. It's influenced by the Al Undercover. Sadly, I couldn't do the picture big enough because I would have wanted to finish the headpiece off, or what the head should have looked like. The head should have been way bigger than that, and the sword obviously be way bigger than that. And I didn't do the backpack properly because I just didn't have enough room for it to make like the full picture and stuff like that. So, you know, yeah. We're gonna take the other deck for a spin. Let's see if this is better than the other thing, because otherwise, I mean, I could probably still make some use of gaming, but I'm gonna have to. I mean, like, even though I don't net deck, I tend to look up other decks sometimes just to take inspiration and see what kind of works. It might be a setting on the screen that makes it like dark like that. Okay, so we probably want to Scopomatic at least, because that immediately counters the priest if he plays her, if he plays the most common priest start, which is, you know, the 1-3, the one. We have turned our curse into strength. And this is really good because this gives me something to play immediately. Hellos and greeting. If he has nothing to play next turn, then I'm just gonna immediately, you know. Then I'm just gonna play something else and not play a Scopomatic. I wanted to encounter this. Okay. I really like the effect that he has, actually. I wonder if these are. I mean, this has to be custom, right? Depending on the class. I believe it always is. Okay, so. This is actually better. Of course, we could play one of the Rush minions. Or I could use to this. Wait, didn't it say, oh yeah, it only adds 1 to your hand, it doesn't add 2, that would be too powerful. Yeah, I could magnetic and onto that as well. That might actually be worth to magnetize. Or do I? Hopefully that does not die. If it does not die, then I'm probably gonna annoy module. Or otherwise I could just place a spark into the annoy module, if that is the case. But yeah, because this will add 4 health to it. So if he doesn't kill that, he isn't killing that, okay. I mean, he could have Shadow Word Death, that's the whole thing. But he would have played probably Shadow Word Death, or maybe he's waiting for that to get buffed even more. That could be a strategy, of course, because he already has a taunt out, because it's not worth spending the Shadow Word Death and killing that off, and then you just leave me at 2-4. I'm gonna do that at least, because otherwise I'm just gonna be able to, like, play the Rush 1 and then Magnetic into that, and then use Guardian. Even though that's not gonna kill it off, but it's still gonna kill it off. Okay. So I'm thinking he's waiting to kill her off. So I'm gonna do this. And I could of course magnetize the disc, but that would be bad for my board currently. Which is why you could, for example, spend 7 on this. You could spend 7, you could rush and magnetic basically. So we could make this stronger instead. And it's better to do that actually than put it all on one. In case the Shadow Word's pain or Shadow Word death. The bad thing is he might have Shadow Word pain and just use it on the 3-7. So it dies, but then it will be replaced by another taunt, so... This might be more control-oriented than the other thing is, which is just... Okay. So he will be taking damage with that. I could of course magnetize that onto something. I would really like to magnetize that actually into this. Because then it's 4-5-6, then it's a 6-6 basically. But then you have spent 12 mana on that to be a 6-6, but then it's almost a 7-7, so that would kind of be worth that stats of 7-7 plus 6-6, so it's like 12, 13, 14, so it's 14 worth of mana, so 14, so 12, 14, basically worth of stats. And 12, 14 seems decent enough actually for stats wise. Especially considering you have this effect too, you know. This can kill off weaker stuff, but it can of course kill off your own stuff as well. And he's probably angry, that's probably why he's burning, because they think that haha, this will make it so my opponent will use Rage Quit, because that's the only reason why people do it, you know. But we could in worst cases use that as well, you know. So do I do that and use the rush? I think I'm gonna do this. No, we're not gonna be able to rush with that. So I'm gonna have to wait until next turn probably. Or I mean I could kill that off, yeah, let's kill that off actually. And then I'm just gonna magnetize this into the thing. I could just kill the dragon off and then just... I don't get it, why they are rage quitting, why even play the game at that point. But sometimes someone may quit, not because of raging, because that's the whole thing always, that it's called rage quit for a reason. Are they stupid to call everything rage quit? That's just the whole you know, like 12-year-old mindset, you know, that everyone has, you know, play games. It seems like that always, because people always do. Or like they think they know everything, you know, or whatever, you know. Okay, this isn't as good of a start, I would say. But I mean, they are still useful even when you don't have magnetic on certain of the mechs. But certain of the mechs aren't as powerful as others, but it's still important just to get the mechs out on the board. Because this is really good, this means that you always have an opening, basically. Yeah, my one mana thing. Okay. Oh, he's gonna make it take damage immediately. Ooh, interesting. So I'm gonna be able to kill it off with this. Okay, and then I can add a rush to my hand. I could add a rush to my hand, and then well, I won't trade in anything because I could use auto damage him right now, currently. So he's gonna have to trade if he wants to. I don't know if he has any way to heal though. If I should use trade in these. The That depends on if he can kill it off or not. He might be able to if he uses a weapon. But then wasting a swing of a 3-2 weapon is not worth it. Yeah, he's gonna trade into that, okay. I mean, that's fine, that's better than him damaging my face already. So since he hasn't killed her off, I'm gonna be able to use this. I could use the wrong face there, but it's better to use the thing with that. Even though now he has a lot of armor because of that. This is still pretty decent, is that? Although I would buff its health, actually. I would buff it to being a 6-7 or a 6-8. That's the hell of a thing, and then you have like... What? Did this grant me really? Hello. Nope. Okay, Ooh, magnetic, ooh. Oh, that could be bad. Hello. That might be bad. Oh no, that's actually perfect. Sure, he will kill everything. I mean, that could be a good way to trigger this. I guess I could trigger this with this. I want some of that now because... Oh man, he probably has an execute though. He's probably gonna wait me to E and think. Yeah, execute. Yeah, nice. But that will summon a bunch of stuff. Yeah, at least he summoned one once. Sadly, I don't have. Do I have more mechanized? Maybe I don't. Add two sparklers to your hand. So that could go face. So then we'll put this here. Yeah, I probably shouldn't have spent that extra one there. I thought about spending that on like whatever it would be when it died. But I mean, this is really good to make it one cost, okay? Okay, so he thought that was my biggest threat then, maybe. Maybe that's his thought process. They seem to be a really slow warrior. It might be a recruit one, actually. Actually, let me get this and see if I can get any. Ooh, this is really, really powerful right now. Because I can play a zero man on that. One man I could just play a. Two mana for that, and I can just play this to kill something off. Yeah, his AoE thing is really good. Ooh, this is powerful. Discover a mech, you could discover something really powerful with that. Well, let me check here. I'm gonna deal 3 damage, and that could be to anything. Okay, so I know more 1. Okay, that's important to know, at least. That's important to know. So let's just go face. Even though this isn't that much damage, I mean, it's... much damage is that? That's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, or 7 damage every turn, at least. As much damage each turn. And the thing is, if we play stuff, then I can just... Yeah, okay, that's really, really bad. I will probably get rid of 2 of my 1-1 stone instead. Oh, this is actually good for me. This is actually perfect. This is probably what I want. And this is what I want. So So get rid of some space here. And then we... should I rush? Yeah, probably. This has rush itself. So we'll get some 2-1-1s. We have another rush. And another one. And another one. Popping some Red Bulls. Or, yeah, Red Bulls. Prot Monster and... and Holy Nocco. Or Nocca or whatever they call it. Actually, let me show you that monster, by the way. Oh, sorry, I know the milfs like to see it when I show my ass. This flavor. The purple one. Ultraviolet. This is inspired by the 80s or the 70s. And it smells so fucking good. And it's actually something weird. There's like elderberry, which is flatter in Swedish. And then black... carrot
juice.
So this is sugar free also because it's in the Alto series. So yeah, this is purple. Hello. Hello. Oh man, I love it. I love it so much. Okay, what did he do? Blast seal. Okay, ooh, nice. So we want to do what exactly? So he has that, okay. And I cannot kill that. Okay. Wait, that's okay, granting max rush, okay, so death rattle, okay. So yeah, okay, he mechanized that, okay. We don't need the set feed. So let's just do this for now. Let's just do that for now, and then we can trade in the... It feels so weird summoning a 700 crew, so why haven't they made it special for... It's of the Paladin Heroes. Like, I don't think Blood Knight recruits would be make that much sense because Blood Knights don't technically have recruits. I think they're often more called them initiate. Like, because not everything is a recruit just because something is new. Initiate makes more sense. It depends on how the caste system is, as you call it. Oh yeah, that's a super collider, which is nasty. Oh, and yeah, he had a thing there. And actually, this is... this could be bad, so let's do this here. So we're doing this. Oh, I could have summoned the thing. But I'm not gonna do that. I thought about summoning another one, because then I would have gotten 3-3-3s. Instead, but he's already gonna have to trade into that. And it might have been worth using that. Yeah, okay, so I shouldn't have done that. I should have thought that he had a super collider. And he's gonna be able to use the trading in three of those into that to kill it off. Right, and that's when a friend minion dies. Yeah, okay. Oh no, no, that's when they attack, okay. So he can go face, yeah. Okay, so this is gonna be scary. If this had taunt, it would be so much better though. I don't think he's... What's that effect? Okay, that's the blast shield. I'm gonna have to do this. And I'm not gonna purple anything else. The main problem is he's still gonna be able to deal a lot of damage to me because he's still gonna be able to attack. The question is, what is he willing to do? Question. If I can get this off, I'm gonna be able to stabilize quite a bit. This is great, going up against a control warrior actually. I miss the days of a lot of control warriors actually. So is he gonna kill that off with... Okay, so he's gonna execute that. And then it's gonna deal 10 damage to me, or he's gonna deal 11. I'm almost dead. He might hit me with the weapon. Okay, so... Oh, I can still do this. It's not over yet. Do I? It's worth taking one damage. It is worth cleaning that off. The costing needs to use both. Unless he goes face on it. But he might not think about that. He might not think about... Oh yeah. It's doing Aspringer. Man, if he doesn't deal with it this turn, well, no, he's gonna be able to deal with this. He's just gonna be able to do that. I didn't even get my doctor off. At least he said that I was good. You know, that's something at least, you know. That was a fun game, actually. Because, I mean, this is a bit of a weird deck. You could probably make something strong, though, with Greymane. I just haven't found out what yet. I just want to experiment. Because that's the thing, like, you cannot make a deck justice until you, like, you have to revise your own decks, you know, and stuff like that. You have to figure out, okay, what is working, what is making me lose with the deck, you know. And then you have to try out against many different opponents, because you might lose one day against like everything, but then the next day you're on an amazing spree or whatever, you know. It might just be that this deck is way worse than the other one. Oh, this seems good. Since we don't have any early stuff, I can just press Crystallogy immediately. I could use Demon Corn, Crystallogy. That might actually be better than getting out the one mana thing. Since this is basically draw two. Oh, that's a Cabal background. Yeah, and that's gonna be nerfed down to 2 mana actually, which is really good. They're actually nerfing a classical. Oh! Wait, we can explode our pumpkins. Is that first secret quest? I think that would make sense. Okay, so... Counted! Oh, the Scorpion is gonna be so good when they make it cost 2 and then they play it on 2 and then you counter it still with the Scopomatic. The Scopomatic is so used incredibly good because of those situations. See, it basically affects every card in my hand right now. I could have, yeah, it's just gonna be insane, and then this is gonna become 1. I'm gonna be able to make this cost 3, and I'm gonna make Annoyatron's cost 2. Okay, so it's a control mage, because otherwise he wants to kill it off. He could use 5 blast on his own thing, if he really would want to. So this, into this. Into this. He might have another mana worm though, probably coming up eventually. And now I can do some shenanigans with this. I can just spread this out on 2 different minions instead. Black probably magnetize the Scorpion to see what it looks like in gold. Or, you know. Okay, so he's gonna kill off. Okay, good. Please don't kill my Scorpion. Thank you. Ohio. No. What is it? What is the thank you? I forgot what it was in Japanese. Ooh. That's actually very, very... That's big it up to a 4. A 4-3. But that's not good to use right now. It's better to use this. I could, though, immediately do that and buff it up even more. But the question is, do we have a fireball in his hand? If he has a fireball in his hand, he can kill it, but he could also use Tapa Sheep on his hand. And then we're wasting the magnetic thing, so I'm gonna do this instead. And I'm gonna kill that off. Okay, so now we know we don't have any more one cost thing. That has happened twice now. So it might not be worth running 2 Crystallogies. Crystallogy seems like a dead card then. So we don't want one, we only want one Crystallogy in our deck. Most likely. Yeah, so that's a change we can already do to the deck. We don't want 2 Crystallogies, 2 games in a row at least. Or we should at least make 100 more game. So, So he might not have the fireball in his hand then, because why would he hold back on that? So do I use 2 into 4? Or I could just buff this up even more with this. Yeah, let's just do this here. And this might be bad now if he's sitting on a fireball. If he got the solution now, then it's good. Like, if he plays this card and it's the solution, yeah, he top deck the polymorph, he top the deck it. That's just the thing I hate the most about Hearthstone, when stuff like that happens. Oh, he top deck it. It would be like, I couldn't play around that. Oh, top decking, that's something you cannot play around. You cannot play around them top decking something like that, you know, so that's a bit bad. We could play again and hope that he polished this. But yeah. So this is pretty bad, I would say. Alright, I could have attacked probably with minion. I forgot to do that, I think. No, I actually went into okay. So he's gonna be able to kill that off. But that makes him waste his flame strike. That seems weird to waste the flame strike on that. So do we 6, 7, 8. So I want to play the combo. So we're gonna do this. We're gonna do this. I mean, I only need to attack twice for it to give it to a minion in your hand, and then this is gonna become more powerful next turn because I'm gonna be able to attack something. It doesn't matter what I attack. Hopefully he doesn't play a big taunt or anything. Okay, so the griffon is there, but why didn't they make a spectral griffon then? Okay, so so now we do this, we kill this off. Boom. That became a 6-3. Oh man, that's really powerful. So and I'm gonna be able to. This is also powerful, but I don't wanna play this immediately. Because the main problem with that is of course the thing. Wait, why didn't I get Valinir back? What happened to my Valinir? The Valinir should have come back when it buffed something up. Or does it go back into the deck? I could still magnetize that. Or I can magnetize this instead. So that's a 6-3. This is still good though to play. But I thought the Valinir was gonna come back. I kinda wish you could scroll this down though. That you could have black buttons here and scroll it down to see. Because I thought it said like resummon this weapon. Or whatever, maybe it doesn't resummon it. Oh, he's going face, he's not killing it off. That's actually good for me. Okay, so I would normally play that, but I don't think he can deal that much damage though. Yeah, this can spiral out of control very, very quickly. I don't think he's gonna be someone that runs the... This belongs in a museum. Although it's just so fucking good to run in pretty much every deck. Or like, depending on the opponents that you go up against. And if you notice them actually play a weapon and stuff like that. Like if you're like lower in the tiers, then you might not notice no one is playing weapons or whatever. But if you're running into a lot of people that play weapons, then Harrison is so good. Because Harrison draws cards depending on the durability of the weapon. So that has rush. So that counters this immediately. I could make it a 6-2 otherwise, but it would still die. So I actually want to play all of these, even though they cannot go face. I missed out on some damage there. I didn't actually want to deal more damage, so I would probably have lethal there. So 1, 2, 3, 4 more damage, so I would have had him down to 11 there. I missed calculator there. Okay, so that's bad. No more buffs. Imagine if he would have gotten the 11-3 there, but that wouldn't have mattered. I would have just been able to kill it off because he couldn't kill off any of my stuff. Why does he do that? He could still go for the 11-3 and just do that and hope that I wouldn't. Yeah, I don't want to waste this time though and just, you know. And of course that was probably just someone using a classic deck, so, you know. And by the way, the weird thing with this is that it smells like Smoltron, which is raspberries. It basically smells like raspberries. And it's weird, like, why does it smell like raspberries when it's like, when it's just elderberry and black carrot juice? But maybe carrot juice, maybe black carrot juice is not real carrot juice. Maybe it's just a mix of things, or maybe black... Oh, maybe... Because black carrots are fermented carrots, right? It's like black garlic or fermented garlic, and fermented garlic is actually better for you than regular garlic is. You know, so if you're a garlic lover or you're Jim Sterling, you know. Jim Sterling actually looks like an old friend of mine, actually. By the way, he looks exactly like that person. But he's, not, of course, not from the UK, that person is. Okay, so Valera. I really like the effect there, the confetti effect. But then why couldn't they use the made it to have a party hat? Party hand recruit. Silver party recruit. Uther party man. Guy thing. Okay, so. So. Hopefully he doesn't trade that into something. Because, yeah, I can just get a value from this. Yeah, that's actually a pretty good boom, and then he's just gonna trade in that. If he leaves that alive, then it's gonna be really good. That's interesting, why didn't he take face damage there and leave his 1-1 like that, but... I'm just gonna do this instead. So we have got enough one of the effects, although we will only be able to hit two targets, it's still very good. This is still probably a good turn play now, the next turn. Because we put that into this, and it becomes 4-4-4-3 basically. And then you summon 3 1-1s, which is really good right now, because he seems to only have small minions. But it could be that he has a lot of spells. Keep in mind, not every netdecker is a good person not playing in the game. That's the main problem with people that netdecks, that they don't understand how to play the deck. And even if there are guides, that isn't the same thing as experience. You need experience playing a deck. Which is why I always like to create my own stuff. Because I tend to create stuff I already have experience with, like playing like that kind of playstyle. Like, I've noticed that I have certain playstyles, like I know how to play Control Paladin really well, for example. Which is why, like, I'm worse at like going face sometimes, but I learn to go face better due to playing other classes. But yeah, so this is, could be good as well to do. The main problem is I'm not going to kill that off, because I know that he will use poisonous, then poisonous rush, and he's just going to trade into that now and kill it off. But it was still worth doing that, just for the extra damage. And then I'm going to be able to mechanical whelp next turn, or spark drill. Sparkle could be good to trade that into his poisonous thing. They have rush, right? Yes, they do have rush. He might not realize that that has rush, though. Does he realize that it has rush? But some people don't realize that it has rush. Okay. He did realize that. Okay, good. He's doing the right thing, because that's the thing, when you have magnetic, then all mix immediately become dangerous. So I could actually do some fun stuff here. So yeah, I probably won't kill that off, or should I? Yeah, let's do this so I can just... Because he's probably not going to be able to buff that up, and yeah, I'm just going to be able to rush in with something right away. I could just, in case he plays a lot of stuff now, I could just Sunkeepitarium. Or just play one of these, rush into it and then Sunkeepitarium. I could alternatively use Mechanical Whelp. Okay, so he don't have a Death Rattle out. Okay, so he's making that powerful. That seems like a waste unless he's setting up something that he already has a Death Rattle in the hand that he needs. Ooh, this is good though. So we change our plans then. Rush. Or should I imagine? No, I should 4, 5, 6, so I can still do that, okay. And then this. Well, 5-2. That summons or doesn't summon anything when it dies, or it does summon things when it dies. And then these spark things are so fucking good. But they aren't the same as the micro boss that you summon. So he has that. Okay, so I wanna kill this off. I could have used my other stuff though, but I wanna hold them in the hand actually. I could have also summoned one of these and made that a 3-3. But I don't feel like overextending too much here. That's a pretty smart counter actually to them. Okay, so he's gonna summon some 5-5s. The question is he just gonna wait? No, he's not gonna wait. He's not gonna able to deal one damage unless he has a thing. Okay, ooh. Is this too late to play that? Oh wait, this is gonna be really good. I'm actually gonna do this actually here. And now we're gonna rush. And we're gonna rush something to bring it down to 4. It wouldn't have mattered if the rush minion would have had 1 extra health. That wouldn't have mattered all there. I know I'm missing using the reinforce and stuff there, but it's a pretty good idea to actually do that and just thrust it into something. And then now we basically kill one of his dinos off, basically. That's actually good for him. But he's probably not gonna go face. Alright. He can win with that. Ooh, I didn't realize. What the heck was I thinking? Why didn't I kill off his stuff? I had opportunity to kill off his stuff, but I didn't do it. I got so excited because I was like, oh yeah, I'm gonna win. And then I didn't like calculate how much damage he had on the board. I should have looked at it. I knew he had a lot of damage on the board. I think I didn't calculate in the fact that he had like the thing. That he had like the weapon and stuff. Okay, this is a really bad start. And that's also quite bad. But that still allows me to use this now, twice in a row, in case we get really bad. And this is still good. So, I mean, we have a very, very high chance to drawing a mech. And I think I'm actually gonna record like this in the future to just have the webcam there. I might even go for a smaller one, but there's a way to also make it like a custom webcam backend, but I have no idea if you need like 3D programs or whatever, you know, because I know, for example, that Palatime and, you know, some other ones, they managed to do something for like when you play Heroes of the Storm, they managed to make the whole, where the portrait is of the character, they managed to make it so that your webcam would fit into that portrait, so it would fit exactly where the portrait is and stuff like that, which is pretty cool, you know, that's pretty smart way to putting it, whether it's actually blocking anything, but yeah, but I don't know if you can do custom stuff like that if you play on like Twitch, because apparently you don't in the PC Gamer, the latest episode of PC Gamer. That doesn't seem to do the effect, or maybe it doesn't do the effect for yourself. But it seems weird. I really like how it's... I wonder how much this is gonna glow when it becomes golden and stuff that. Because you see Van recruits are golden, right, when you do that. Why did he do that? I'm gonna draw here because there's a high chance that I draw this again. See? That was way smarter than just playing Galvanizer, because now I have more things that hit. Basically, I hit all the stuff in my hand right now and making them cost one less, which is really powerful. I don't know how much good one stuff thing Shaman is gonna have when it's the Boomstead map. The Boomstead map doesn't seem to become scarier. That's Azeroth, I think. Because that doesn't look like Outland. It looks like you will be able to open this. Oh, there's a plant in there. And it changes into things. There's a boot. So this is a teleporter or a replicating mechanism. Okay. Interesting, and we go this. And make this cost one. And this cost that now, okay, so because he's roping, he is getting very little time again. It might be that it says now after a while, your opponent left. Because it might be that the opponent is disconnecting and then trying to reconnect or whatever. So that's probably what's going on. I would normally just wait for them and stuff like that, but you know, like, yeah. I'm just gonna be able to magnetize something the next turn. I mean, I could wait otherwise just to magnetize this. But I probably won't do that. Probably a person would disconnect or something. Because that just seems very weird. Maybe think that Wormgear, that person is a hack because that person is using a hero who isn't in the game, lol. And then they make an angry phone post about it, like, Wormgear, I met this hacker in the game. So I'm gonna be able to make the combo then. And we're gonna be able to combo that with that. Oh wait, at the end of your turn. Yeah, so it isn't on the end of the opponent's turn, because that would have made it too bad. Oh, now he's actually playing something. I'm guessing he came back. So I thought that I would use the dump on the board. Sometimes people are weird. I can kill my own stuff with that. But that's the thing, if I just keep buffing stuff, like buffing this with this, which is a good one. Oh man, buffing this up. The unpowered Steambot with that is really, really powerful. Because I can play it at 10 mana, I can play this combo. Baron is, of course, really, really good also. But this, for example, this becomes like a 215. It becomes if you buff it with Back Ridge. I'm guessing you're thinking it's gonna fire, maybe. Okay, now I have 7 mana. This is a mech, right? Yeah, this is a mech. So I could just magnetize that. Okay, and it's gonna kill off. It. Doesn't he have lightning bolt? like seriously, you know, make it weaken and you don't have a lightning bolt. Coin, what is it, 2 mana. This is better. Okay, freeze, okay. Well, that totally makes sense. So do I stick on or something? I might stick on the dragon actually because he's attacking that a lot. Oh, I could have just gone face their loops. Then I wanted to say something. Mm. Yeah, this is not too shabby. I mean, the crystal thing, you know, I've said, you know, that I'm gonna modify the deck, but I'm gonna give it more, like, more chance to, you know, to see how often that thing will be when it drops me absolutely nothing, how often that's gonna happen. Because, yes, sure, even if it's a dead card, it's not necessarily a bad thing to have a dead card sometimes. There's like a moon over there. This is kind of the best Halloween map, I would say. Okay, this is not a bad start, actually, because drawing the crystallogies, this is going to be the best thing, because now I'm going to be able to actually see, like, basically, I'm going to have to avoid drawing one cost thing or a one attack thing. That's the main problem, though, that it's only, like, one attack things. So I wonder if you see that explosion or if it's only your... I'm gonna have to try out with another hero and see if you actually see that or not. Because we have only played with another one so far. Okay, so... So this will draw two Scopomatic Galvanizer. And this should draw me the other Scopomatic and Galvanizer. Correct. So that might be when it's only useful. So this is the best. So crystallogy only really works when you mulligan them. But there are really, really strong mulligan them because you just fill your hand immediately. So he's gonna go face, so it's a... Is it a face warrior then? That seems like a really bad matchup for him though. Yeah, it's Scopomatic and Gavans. So that's basically like, yeah, it's just insane how much bigger my hand is now, because that's usually one of my weaknesses, that I used to empty my hand too much, and with the crystallizer it's just so good. And I mean, you could get your really, really powerful one drops. I'm probably just gonna still use the Scopomatic to just kill it off. And I could just go, I definitely want to go with the Galvanizer now. Galvanizer into Galvanizer, and then I could just we could just do this, and I could also do this here. That, by the way, doesn't have rush, but these do have rush, so you can see there's some pretty swag stuff you could do. And then I could just trade in this, but he's probably gonna kill it off with the thing. Maybe. I'm fast, I'm furious! Oh, really? Okay, that makes sense. Kinda. Sometimes there are certain people who don't trade in stuff unless you can trade evenly. Okay, so this could be... This is actually pretty good right now. Because this is gonna deal 1 damage to everything. And then this is gonna deal 3 damage to me, and unless he has a weapon. Unless he has a weapon, then it's not gonna kill it off. And even if he kills it off, I can use the guard on something. Execute.
Yes.
So one execute is down, so we don't need to worry about that so much. So I could just play this for ceremony and then just play magnetic. Or I could magnetic this. A 3/10 that summons 3 1/1s. Yeah. Oh, and I can missile launch that and then stick order on it as well. Stick order might actually be better to do in case he just damages it and then does the thing. And I'm probably gonna do missile launcher on to the annoy module instead. When I can at 8 mana. Instead of just putting it on into one card, because he's gonna eventually be able to execute that once he gets his second execute. But if he doesn't have enough card draw, then he's not gonna reach his second execute. It might be executed already. But then I'm gonna summon 3/3s and not 2/6. So since he's not dealing with that, let's do this first. And I'm gonna do this here. And that's gonna do this. Oh, I thought both of them would shoot missiles. Oh no, it's only that one. Oh, this is gonna kill off my raptors. That's actually pretty smart of him. Okay, that's actually a pretty smart comeback, so. I never thought about doing that actually with that, to be honest. Okay, but that is pretty smart. He has a lot of armor, so I want to spend it. So, do I want to magnetize something else here? I could rush into, yeah, this is gonna be good here. Rush into this. And there's an A2 with rush. I could go face with it, or if I spare it, so do this here. So I wanna do that actually, and then I wanna be able to go face with this. That's why I waited basically. Oh yeah, that's really really bad, but I'm gonna be able to attack with that. I'm gonna be able to go face with that because rush only is rush during the first turn basically. After that it's just like a regular minion. Hello. That's a thank you. I kind of wish they would tell people which ones you choose, that they would be able to see where your pointer is, and they would be able to see. Okay, that's actually pretty bad. I mean, that still gives me 3 of those, and I can rush as well. And I can just kill it off, right? Nope, I cannot kill it off, so. So this was almost a thing. Right, so we want to. This curse has become our greatest strength. I'm not gonna go trade into that because then he will summon the taunt thing. And it's up to him if he wants to attack something with it and summon a taunt. Because I can just deal with the taunt pretty easily. Because I already got 3. Okay, this is bad. That's actually perfect to deal with that. Sadly, he doesn't have any one cost things yet. That might be worth playing eventually, but not yet. So let's. I'm actually gonna do this first and then play this. Because then I have a chance to actually do this, to trade that into that. Because I think he spent both executes. This is bad though. If he gets the right hero power, and he did get the right hero power, that can just target anything. I wonder if he knows how to use that, or if he thinks it's. Yeah. Lucky him. It's not always that cannon at the start, it's random basically. That's basically like really really good for him, but he's not able to kill that often, which is really good though. And this is really powerful right now. Oh, I could have used summoned it first and then done the thing. So that becomes a 1/2. Not worth doing anything with that yet. But this is like a really, really good weapon, you know, in case he has I think it's really annoying though to deal with. The question is he gonna try and kill everything I have on the board? Or is he just gonna go face? If he goes face, that's kind of a mistake. They can't go face though, they're small robots. They have to go and take something else because they're rush, basically. They become rush. Which is actually worse. Because certain mechs, I mean, it's not really that bad, but they cannot go face immediately. If it would, instead of being charged, then it would have been overpowered, basically. But yeah, I thought about... So that's the wow thing. You literally have to listen to what he says to. This makes sense. Ooh, Lich King. But, I mean, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Depends on what. Okay. So we need to him. And then I need to do this. I need to kill this off too, so it becomes weaker. And then I now have a 9-9 and a 2-2. Oh, destroy all me. Oof. That is good if he would have less, but this would remove way too many cards right now. Okay, so. He's gonna be able to kill it off. But he's not gonna. Yeah, he's gonna be able to use trade one of his fours into it. But does he really want. Oh man, killing that thing off is not a good idea though. Or maybe it is. And then it's gonna go face with the rest. This might actually be worth using. This might be worth using actually. I really want to use this though. I'm gonna have to use it. Because I take 3 damage. Or I take 2 damage. Brings me down to 4. 4, 5, 6, yeah, he has lethal now, so I need to destroy. Goodbye Tyrion, goodbye thing. Okay, so that's good. Hopefully he cannot get through this. Hopefully it doesn't have mortal strike, what is this? This is Discover Mech. And the range Doctor might proc. If he has rush then it's bad, or if he has any way to remove Divine Shield. But if he doesn't have a way to remove Divine Shield, then I'm at a good spot because then I'm finally gonna be able to use that. That's the main problem I have with the range Doctor, that is just so expensive. Yeah, so unless he has mechs. He might have something. He does not have something, and I can just immediately do this here. Time for the comeback, the most epic comeback of all time. I'm starting the next episode on.